What's up, SciFam? It's your boy Nickel, and today we're going to look at medical interventions. You might be asking yourself, whoa, man, this is some crazy stuff happening. How come we don't just have all of our really smart people come up with some drugs or vaccines or antibody therapy to help treat us and fix everything? Well, let me help explain a little bit more about vaccines, antibody therapy, and some other drugs that are we're trying to figure out what the heck we can do to help people out in a medical arena. So the first thing, and I put this first because this one is going to probably be the most useful for us, is a COVID-19 vaccine. So a vaccine is a really powerful tool because it can be given to healthy people, healthy individuals, to actually train their immune system. And it trains our immune system to be able to recognize and combat, so like fight, specific pathogens. And in this case, the pathogen would be SARS-CoV-2, because a pathogen is either some type of bacteria or it's some type of virus. And so you might have heard of other types of vaccines. Well, those vaccines are basically small amounts that are given to somebody so that their body can learn how to combat and recognize that, so that if the real one were to come, then the body can attack it and destroy it so that that virus is not able to affect the body. So what ends up happening is when you give a person a vaccine would cause your body, your own body, to create from scratch its own antibodies. So it identifies the pathogen, the specific pathogen. In this case, the pathogen would be SARS-CoV-2, that virus. When a vaccine goes into your immune system with a little bit of that virus, your immune system is actually able to start creating these things that we call antibodies, and those antibodies would become really important, but it can create it from recognizing this pathogen. It's an amazing function that our body has. And so let's define what an antibody is, though, and see what it actually does. So it's a type of protein in our blood. It's a blood protein that is going to chemically attach to the pathogen, in this case the virus. It's a blood protein that chemically attaches to the pathogen, so the immune system can find it if it enters again and then destroy it. So if we give a COVID-19 vaccine to healthy people, it means that if they were to contract COVID-19 disease, their body would already know how to take care of it on their own. Their bodies would have these things we call antibodies in it already. Those antibodies would go and attack it. So for example, I know like I have a hepatitis vaccine. And so if hepatitis were to enter my body, my immune system already knows how to fight it because I have those antibodies that have built up from the vaccine that I took. All right, so another thing that we need to then look at is this COVID-19, if we look specifically at this vaccine, if they create a vaccine, they have to try to figure out a way for it to target those S proteins. Because if they can affect those S proteins, then it can't dock to the ACE2 receptors. So we want to create a vaccine that can target the virus S proteins and stop it from being able to dock onto those cells. Now, this takes a really long time to get it all through the different regulatory agencies and stuff. But right now, actually, since we're in such a crisis mode, trials have begun in the state of Washington. So in the U.S. here, we're kind of leading that vaccine front, trying to figure out a vaccine to try to help everybody out. And it's begun in Washington state to test the vaccine's effectiveness and to see if it causes this process that's called immune enhancement. So let's slow down and explain this. First, the effectiveness. If we give a vaccine to 100 people and only helps one person, that's not going to be an effective vaccine. So we have to make sure that the vaccine actually works at targeting those S proteins. But also, we want to make sure that the vaccine does not enhance your immune system, because There are some vaccines that have been made in the past. For example, this one that was called the RSV, a certain virus vaccine. It enhanced people's immune systems, and their immune systems went so crazy that it actually started attacking their healthy body, and it caused people to get extremely sick because their immune system just went so crazy. It went into overdrive, like way more than it needed to. So we don't want that to happen. That would be really, really dangerous. That if we came up with a COVID-19 vaccine and it wasn't fully tested and we didn't know, and if it started to cause immune enhancement, it could cause people to get more sick and they wouldn't even have the actual disease. It would just be their immune system freaking out. Don't want that to happen. So we got to test it. And so those trials have begun in Washington State, where they're giving people a small dose, then they'll give them a medium dose of the vaccine, and then a large dose of the vaccine to see what happens, so that they can try to say, oh, all you need is this amount, or maybe you need this much, or maybe you need all of this in order for it to actually work, or maybe you need a trial, maybe you just need these two, or maybe you need all three of them. So they got to figure it out. We don't want to just pass out these vaccines and cause people to get immune enhancement or even get sick from it if we don't know how it works. So let's move on to number two. Number two, the second thing that could really help us out would be a COVID-19 antibody therapy. So we talked about those antibodies. They're those blood proteins that chemically attach to the pathogen, the virus, so the immune system can find it and destroy it. Our body usually naturally makes those. And so it takes those blood antibodies. If we made this as a medical intervention, so if we had humans actually administer the antibody therapy, it would mean that we're taking blood antibodies from individuals who actually were infected by the virus and recovered. So basically what happened in their bodies, their immune system was able to beat out that virus. So therefore they ended up creating those antibodies. So if we take those antibodies from their blood and then inject them into seriously ill or sick patients, or use it, we could even use it as some type of prevention. So if we had those antibodies from people who overcame the disease, then they would have those antibodies. We could take them from their blood and put them in people so that maybe people were healthy and then they could have those antibodies. Or if people were really, really, really sick, we could give them those antibodies so that those antibodies could go and find the virus and kill it. Now, if we have someone who's seriously ill, they're going to need a lot of those antibodies. So if we got the antibodies from a healthy person, we'll say we got one healthy person that overcame the virus. If we took the antibodies from them, it could help one seriously ill person. So it's kind of a tough thing to use because we would need a lot of people who overcame it to help a lot of seriously ill people, which means we would need a lot of blood banks to collect the blood. We need a lot of high-tech equipment as well. Now, if we wanted to give it to people to help prevent COVID-19 and some people, we could find that one person that overcame it. And if we're using it for prevention, we don't need as much of the antibodies. So one person could actually treat dozens of other people. But still, if we're looking at the whole population of the United States or the whole population of the world, we have to find a ton of people who have overcome this disease in order to administer it to enough people. And again, we would need lots of blood banks, and we'd have to keep that not contaminated. We need a lot of extra equipment as well. So even though this is a good strategy, it actually would take a lot of really challenging obstacles. We'd have to really overcome those challenging obstacles to make that work. But it's at least one of the tools in the toolkit. And the third one that's less of a specific way that we're positive that we can really help, but it's a way that scientists are still doing some research to try, because we're right now all hands on deck trying anything, is to look at different RNA virus drugs, because we've actually developed some drugs that target different RNA viruses. So as we know, SARS-CoV-2 is a virus that contains RNA. That RNA is injected into a host cell because the SARS-CoV-2 is a parasite. It forces the host cell to make tons of the copies of the RNA. So if we could somehow get a drug that's been made for another RNA virus and adapt it, that would be awesome. So RNA virus drugs, we would need to repurpose drugs that have been effective in combating other RNA viruses. And so we'd want to find an RNA virus that looked or acted similar to SARS-CoV-2 and then use that to then try to modify it so it could attack SARS-CoV-2. So we'd want to modify them to attack, yes, like I said, SARS-CoV-2, because that's the name of the virus that's causing COVID-19. Now, there is actually one promising drug. And this drug, I probably am not pronouncing this correctly, but it's called Remdesivir or something like that. You can see it spelled there. So Remdesivir. It has been, since it's kind of a promising drug, they've expedited it because these are desperate times. So they've expedited it through the approval process. Because we don't want to give a drug to people if we don't know it works or that it's going to cause more harm. So we want to make sure that it's not going to cause more harm and that it does work. And the results from that process of putting it through all the trials, those are expected in April 2020. So we'll see if that's going to actually give us any help. But these are really the ideas that doctors have or that the medical community has in terms of how we can fight this from a medicine perspective. But it's not so simple. And that's why they're asking us all to try not to contract this disease, because we don't have really any medical interventions at this point except for our own body's natural antibodies. So stay healthy out there, folks, and I hope that now you know more about SARS-CoV-2, COVID-19. I'll catch you next time, folks. Peace.